The Vega Facellia was a truly ambitious undertaking. It was envisaged as a challenger to Porsche and Alfa Romeo in the late 1950s. Its young French manufacturer, Facel, wanted to enter a new segment. 1959 saw the launch of a new little Facel called the Facellia. The two-seater sports car was unveiled to the public at the Paris Motor Show. The Facellia went down well among well-heeled car drivers, with 1,000 units ordered before the year was out. Being seen behind the wheel of a Facel was very much en vogue. Available as both a convertible and coupe, the Facellia came with a specially designed engine, a four-cylinder unit with two overhead camshafts. The 1.6-liter power plant delivered about 115 horsepower. The Facellia competed in the mid-range luxury sports car segments as vintage car fan beat Loi. It was pitted against the Alfa Giulietta and Porsche 356, but its price tag put it out of contention. It ended up costing almost as much as a Jaguar E-Type. On the outside, the Facellia was clearly related to Facel's larger luxury models packing a V8 engine. But the designers gave the little speedster little in the way of the American styling seen in previous models. With or without a roof, it cut a fine figure. The rear had a bold, chunky design with slope lights. It was flamboyant and glamorous, Paris-style haute couture. Facel had already made itself a name in the industry as a coachmaker for other manufacturers. In the early 1950s, explains our vintage enthusiast, Facel built top-class bodies for car makers, such as Simca and, to a lesser extent, Bentley. In 1954, when Jean Deninos took over at the top, they decided to become a luxury French car manufacturer. The firm's experience paid off. The interior was dominated by lush leather and carpets, though the finish was not what you'd get from a volume producer. The Facel Vega brand was also known for its dashboards, which look like they're made of wood, but are actually painted metal. The young car maker planned to shift up to 2,000 Facelias a year, an ambitious target. But the innovative new engine proved the downfall of both the model and its maker. A large number of the engines failed, costing Facel dearly in terms of both warranty repairs and reputation. The company decided to install a new superior engine, but it was too little, too late. The first engine had been commissioned from Pont-à-Mousson, better known for its gearboxes. Borrowing from Alfa Romeo, it had two overhead camshafts and ample revs. But more aggressive drivers who wanted to get the most out of the four-cylinder unit were often left stranded with a bust engine. And the switch to a Volvo engine was not enough to save the Facellia. It was a cross between excessive ambition and poor business partnership. Within next to no time, the cars had a disastrous reputation, thanks to the infamous engine. And that meant the end of Facel. Sehr anfälligen Motores einen so tödlichen Ruf, dass es Facel das Genick gebrochen hat. Facel replaced 300 engines in the interest of customer relations, relations it would soon no longer have. In 1964, the young luxury French car maker shut down forever. Today, the Facellia is a great option for vintage enthusiasts after an exclusive classic car for a less than exclusive price. A convertible in good condition will cost you around 35,000 euros. The engines in the later models, as we now know, are more reliable. A Facellia is ideal if you want a special car that many people will recognize as a Facel, but not the exact model. The final version, the F2B, had a decent engine, so there were no more overheating problems. The Facellia, a diva of a car, with a fascinating allure, but no shortage of idiosyncrasies.